Amen. Amen. Somebody who has never talked. Today is your time to talk. Where is your hope? Somebody is raising their hand. Really? Amen. 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 Somebody is looking down so that I don't point at her. Yesterday I heard somebody saying like this, that there are more ladies in the church because women are eager to learn. So what do I say about the men? Stop me saying no. So women are eager to learn than the men. Is it true? The numbers can say it. Amen. I heard a lady shout to the top of her voice like that. I said, hey, a woman in the men. Amen. The proportion of ladies and gents in the church is questionable, isn't it? Yeah, this query must be answered by somebody. Where is your hope? Abigail is almost answering. Yeah, just try. Where is your hope? If we are hopeless, then we should not live. Because you have no hope. Just say it loudly. I'm hearing. Abigail, I'm not moving. Everybody will speak. Today, everybody will speak. I'm telling you. Where is your hope? In your parents? In the schooling? I'm trying to look for where this hope is. Okay, let me. I paraphrase that very, very query. I put it in another way. When we sire children, when we give birth to children, we look at the children as the next person in command taking after me. Do we shift our hope in them somehow? When we see them as responsible people, we feel good. When they start helping us wipe the floor, wash the socks, wash the dishes. Yeah? Then we start saying, that is the next mother-in-law to take over. That is the next father to take over. Am I saying something? So where is our hope? We hope in our children? Really? David G sang a song. David G sang a song and it goes like this. Oh, Iggy, Iggy, Baba, my trust is in you. Isn't it? So where is your hope? Maybe you're not trusting in God. Somebody said some people trust in chariots and horses. Where is your hope? Really? Now only one person is really answered it. You know, I want you to take note of one thing. There's somebody in the Bible who the Bible explains the attributes that he had. He had a character that was very influential. And although he was a normal human being, there are people from atop who relied on him. Why? Because he was very responsible. People will rely on you when you are responsible. When we have children and they have some funny characters in them, we spank them, we smite them, we slap them, we beat them. What are you beating? You are beating that character out, the evil character, isn't it? But if you beat them, you're going to kill them. Okay, some of us, we love them to the point that we don't beat them. Push on them. But at some time, a time reaches when they go out of hand. Now you can never correct them. Just have to bear with it. Amen? I'm looking at the character of Daniel. In Daniel chapter 1. Just go there. Daniel chapter 1. Daniel had very many qualities of good responsibility that even the king who was above him looked at him and said, "What a man." Hope in people comes when integrity grows. A person of integrity exists because of what people see in him. And people see in him these things. People see the things people see in him, they start seeing them early. When we look at Jesus, at age 6, age 12, he was already answering questions in the temple and baffling people and answering some questions that people were saying, "Who is he? Why is he talking this way?" Look at the children that you have. Is there some intelligence in them? When a pastor looks at us, he sees all of us as children to him as well. He has brought us up. He looks at each and every person, and we are gifted differently. So, what a pastor can do is just to steward or to groom that gifting that you have so that it blooms. To bloom is to expand. It expands for the betterment of the people around you and the people in your future. Because somebody like Daniel, Daniel chapter 1 verse 3, the Bible says, "Then the king instructed Ashpenaz, the master of the of his eunuchs, to bring some of the children of Israel and some of the king's descendants and some of the nobles, young men in whom there was no blemish, but good looking, gifted in all wisdom, possessing knowledge and quick to understand, who had ability to serve in the king's palace, and whom they might teach the language and literature of the Chaldeans." Verse 5, "And the king appointed for them a daily provision of the king's delicacies and of the wine which he drank, and 3 years of training for them, so that at the end of that time they might serve before the king." Praise the name of the Lord. The king wants people to work with him. And he sends out some eunuchs, the master of the eunuchs, Ashpenaz, tells him, "Go out there and look for some young men." So, in these young men who are found, verse 6, "Now from among those of the sons of Judah were Daniel, Ananiah, Mishael, and Azariah. To them the chief of the eunuchs gave names." So you've been brought in, then you've given other names. "He gave Daniel the name Belteshazzar, to Hananiah Shadrach, to Mishael Meshach, and to Azariah Abednego." Well, and these four that were chosen, They had some characters that were outstanding. Today, in you as a person, can we find these qualities? Verse 4, young men in whom there was no blemish. They were youths, still young enough to be trained. And then, sharp looking, they were well groomed and well dressed. You look at yourself as a young man. Is your dressing questionable? Does it sag? Are you unkempt? Now, these are the things that were looked at that time. They were well groomed. They were intelligent. The Bible says, verse 4, gifted in all wisdom, possessing knowledge and quick to understand. Possessing knowledge and quick to understand. It means they were intelligent. They had good minds and could process information quickly. Why do we hope in somebody? We hope in somebody because he looks responsible. His character is not wanting. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
So our hope, before it goes to God, even to the people around, we must have hope with them. Because without hope, with the person you see, there is still a question to be answered. Question to be asked. Yes, you hope in God. We all hope in God. But what about one another? Does the person next to you hold some integrity that his character is not wanting? Maybe that is why you want to associate with him or her. Praise the name of the Lord. So I want to tell us this morning that being responsible creates hope in your hearers and in your followers. Amen? Yeah, when people hope in you, when they throw some hope in you, they see your character not wanting. And they can trust you with anything. They say, if it is so and so, we trust him with this, this, that, and that. Without any queries. Amen? Can somebody attest that he is responsible? How many people hope in you? Out there, maybe, at your place of work, maybe, along with your peers, the people whom you hang around with more, your neighbors, maybe somewhere you go buy some things. Do they have hope with you? So this day I want to tell us, we who know the Lord, our character should be in line with Daniel's, because Daniel expressed an array of responsibility. He was very responsible. And this day I believe that somebody says, I wish my son was like this. I wish my daughter was like this. I wish I was like this. On a positive note. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Yes. So I want to tell us, around us and within us, lazima tuwe na kitu ambacho mtu akikiangalia anasema, with so and so at the helm, you are going places. So deeply in you, whatever is there, can ask God, God, change this, change that, change this, but Lord, multiply this. Because I believe that in a person you can't just find all faults. There are some highs, isn't it? that there are some great strengths. And that is what God concentrates on. God concentrates on the strengths. So is a pastor. A pastor concentrates on what you do best. Then he empowers you and puts you in the line that you are gifted in. Can we read verse, chapter 1, verse 17? Yeah, verse 17. As for these four young men, God gave them knowledge and skill in all literature and wisdom. And Daniel had understanding in all visions and dreams. This is Daniel. The king trusts him so much. Why? Because he has got also understanding in visions and dreams. It means that he has gone an extra mile. So it means a well-groomed person and an upright person whom people hope on and is highly responsible. He can go as far as having some understanding in diverse things that make people want to associate with him always. Such was the like as Daniel. Because the Bible says in verse 17, as for these four young men, God gave them knowledge and skill in all literature and wisdom. This speaks about being well informed. People who read a lot, you become well informed. There's no faculty nor any topic that somebody can tell you, talk about this, and you always have an answer. Why? Because you are well informed. Being well informed is good. Knowledge is power. Amen. So they possessed knowledge in a variety of areas, and then they were gifted. They had valuable abilities obvious to others. Yeah, so let us groom ourselves and live up to the rank that people can attest to us that if at all you have such a query or you are undergoing this and that, people can refer to you. They say, I dreamt this way, I don't know the meaning. I saw a vision, I don't know what it means. I fell in a trance, what do I do next? In fact, in matters spiritual, the more you grow, the more God holds you responsible and gives you more responsibility to undertake. It is God who gives. God looks at you, he says, so and so, I think he can carry this. So God gives us gifts in the abilities that we have. That's what the Bible says somewhere in Romans chapter 12. So I will tell us this day that we who know the Lord try to become trustworthy so that you can have some hope. People look at you, they say, if we are with Ariel, we are going to make it. Amen. If we are with Ruth, we are going to make it. Why? Because there is some responsibility that they know you can undertake, and they know that when they are with you, they will never go wrong. Praise the name of the Lord. So I want to tell us this day, measure up. Give yourself time before God. Pray for the things that you really need. Ask God to help you where you are, down to earth. Ask God to energize you, to help you go through. You have a friend, you say so and so is gifted. Get to that person. Get along together. They say somewhere, the Bible says somewhere in Ecclesiastes, it says that two can help, one can help the other if there are two. But if there is one, just fizzle out. Did you come on my car and buy my wife for wajiko? Kiwa moja tu na inawaka, tazima. Kini zikiwa nyingi, ingini nawasha ingini, ingini nawasha ingini, ingini nawasha ingini, they never die out. So, Together we score. Amen. Yes, so let us stay intact together, hopeful with one another. Amen. Yes, I want us to give. I want us to give. Praise and worship can come forward and sing us to God.
Hallelujah.